Your phone is not just a portable distraction for scrolling through social media. It can become your second brain, helping you capture down notes, tasks, and ideas so that nothing slips through the cracks of our finite working memory. So for those hearing about the term second brain for the first time, it's heavily inspired by the works of Tiago Forte, who wrote a book and have course on building a second brain. So do check those out if you'd like to dive deeper. So in this video, I'll show you how I use my phone as a second brain and how you too can transform your phone to work the same way. So building your second brain actually involves several steps, but because of the limited screen space that we have on our phones, it mainly comes down to two actions, so capturing and retrieving. So other steps like organizing and processing information are often done on the desktop instead, or when you're back at your computer. So on our phones, we focus on capturing and retrieving. Starting from my lock screen, I can open up my homepage in Notion in one click using this lock screen shortcut. This is an all-in-one system I've built in Notion, combining what I've learned from David Allen's GDD framework and Tiago Forte's Para framework. Now let's look at how I created this shortcut. First, open the Shortcuts app on your phone. Let me delete this existing one so I can recreate it with you. First, tap the plus icon in the top right to create a new shortcut. Then search for the action from the Notion app. And under the Other heading, you will see a list of Notion pages you have recently opened. If you can't find what you're looking for, simply open up the Notion page in the mobile app for a moment. And then coming back to the Shortcuts app, you should be able to see it as an option. And choosing the page will create an action to open this specific page in Notion. To customize the icon that appears on the lock screen, tap on the drop-down arrow next to the shortcut name, select Choose Icon, and then check the Custom App icon on the right. You can then scroll down to search for a symbol you like to use. Now going to our lock screen, we can hold down the screen until we see the customize button appear, and then we can click on our lock screen to customize it. Then you can tap the minus icon on the respective lock screen control. Next, click on the plus icon to select the shortcut control, which allows us to choose from a shortcut we created in the Shortcuts app earlier. Simply search for the name of your shortcut, which should be your Notion page name. Do note that this is a new feature of iOS 18 which allows us to replace the default flashlight and camera controls. Next, let's explore the different methods I use to capture information on my phone. The previous demo showed how I access my second brain page in Notion from the lock screen, which actually speeds up my workflow for the first capture method, Notion buttons. This is particularly useful for power users of Notion who manage multiple databases. You can set up buttons like the ones at the top of this page for databases you frequently add new pages to. Say I have a project idea, I can click on the new project button, which allows me to write that down. You can also see the different properties I can add below because this page is created in my project's database. Buttons save time in capturing information without needing to first locate the specific page or database. So let's now create a new button together. First, I'll click on the divider, which will give me a list of actions, including the insert below option. I will then click on the plus icon and find the button block. We can go into adding an action and we'll use the add page to action. From here, we can select the database that we want to add a new page to, and you can search or choose the database from the list. I will use my notes database as an example for this button. Next, we can give this button a name and icon so we know what this button is for. I like to use the same icon as the database that I'm creating a new page for easy recognizability. So I actually forgot to add our second action, so below the first action, click add another step and look for the open page tab and then click on select page. And then we'll choose the option new page added, which is the page that we just created from the first step. Now when we click on this button, we'll see a new page created in our notes database. I'll just delete my previous notes button and then I can hold and drag this new button to where I want it to be. And that's it. You can create as many buttons as you need to streamline your workflow. But sometimes we are unsure if something is a task, project, or goal. Nevertheless, what's important is to capture it down. In this case, I use the far right action at the bottom bar in Notion. This action creates a new page under private pages where you can quickly capture the essentials of your thought or idea. When you have time to process which database this item should go to, click on the text private above the keyboard and this should bring up a list and the search function where you can find the appropriate database to move this page to. For example, I can move this page to my task database. And once done, you can see all the different properties and the templates that I can add to this page. Next, I want to talk about how I save things that I find on the internet. I don't save everything right into Notion because there are more suitable tools for different types of content. Besides Notion, I use two other apps, Reader for read later articles, and MyMind for saving design inspiration. First up, if a YouTube video I watch comes to mind as a good reference or inspiration for an active project that I'm working on, I can click on the share icon, and here I can click on the Notion app, which allows me to choose a database or page to add this reference to. It's already selected to my reference database as it defaults to your previous option. And what I like to do before saving this page is just to clean up the page title a little, and that's it. So go into Notion, this is the YouTube video page that we have just saved, and you can see the video embedded in the page body in the URL property field. What we can do next is to click on Add Projects and search for a project to link this reference to. And now, when we open the project page, when we're working on it, we can easily view all the references we have saved from the past. We can click into them to assess the content or review any notes we have taken on the page. So this is for the case where I save an item directly into Notion. So next, if I find an article I'm interested in reading, I'll bring up the share sheet and choose the reader app. If I'm unsure whether something is useful for a project, I avoid saving it directly into Notion to prevent cluttering up my workspace. And besides that, inside Reader, I can enjoy a better reading experience without all the clutter and unnecessary distractions from links. The third type of information I frequently save is design reference. Let's say I come across a visual that I find particularly well designed, I can simply hold down on the image and then click on share and then select the MyMind app. So if I were to open up MyMind, you can see that it beautifully displays your saved items. And when you open a previously saved image, you will see a color palette, an auto-generated TLDR summary, and the relevant text. So being able to browse through these inspirations in MyMind provides a more visually engaging experience compared to a typical page-by-page navigation inside Notion. So these are the different ways to capture down your ideas and inspirations, but if you are looking to learn from the world's best ideas, it brings me to today's sponsor, Shortform. Shortform is a tool I've been using to quickly learn and apply ideas from the best books on productivity, health, and business. So what I like about Shortform is that it goes beyond the standard one-page summary. It's much more comprehensive, covering each chapter and complete with analysis, counterpoints, as well as exercises that you can try out. So for your preference, they also come in audio and PDFs. So in addition to book guides, Shortform actually has a growing library of podcast guides, article guides, and master guides. One more thing, they recently introduced a browser extension that summarizes your internet content with a single click. So this has actually become pretty handy for me in helping me determine whether an article or a video is actually relevant for me, so before I actually invest the time to dive deep into it. So if any of this interests you, you can check out shortform.com/islow, or you can use the link in the description below and you can try out Shortform for free. And if you do end up enjoying it, you can also get a 20% discount on your annual subscription. And back to the video. So now let's talk about my home screen. I have different Notion widgets set up, each connected to a specific page in Notion. For example, when I click on the journal widget, it opens up my journal in Notion, where I can then click on the plus icon to simply create a new entry. So let me walk you through in setting this up on your home screen. So first, I'll hold down on the existing widget to remove it, and then I can hold down on any empty space on the home screen to click on the edit button that should pop up on the top left, and then you should be able to see an option called add widget. So from here, we'll search for the Notion app, and then we can click on it to see all the available widgets. So what we are looking for is the page widget, which should be the first option, and then we can just simply click on add widget. So once it's added to your home screen, you can drag and move it anywhere to where you want it on your home screen. Next, we can tap on this widget to actually customize the page that we want it to open up. So make sure the right Notion workspace is selected before clicking on choose to search for the Notion page. I'll search for my journal page, and the one at the top should be the most recently opened, which is the one I'm using. Once we click done, we can tap on this widget to open our journal in Notion. You can repeat these steps for any Notion pages you frequently access, making them easily accessible from your home screen. In this final segment, I will share the different methods I use to retrieve information from the Notion mobile app. These methods will help you quickly find what you need, when you need it. First, when opening Notion on the Home tab, you will see a section called Jump Back In. I find this feature incredibly helpful for quickly referencing what I was last working on. The major benefit is that it syncs between devices, so if I was just using my computer, it shows me exactly what I was working on there. I certainly hope this Jump Back In feature is extended to the iPad app and the desktop Notion app in the future. Next, below this section, we have Favorite Pages. I use this not only for my frequently accessed pages, but also for projects I'm currently working on. To mark a page as favorite, simply navigate to it, tap the three dots on the top right corner, and then select Add to Favorites. If a page is already marked as favorite, you will see the option to remove it from favorites instead. You can see once I remove this page from favorites, it's now gone from the list. And if I now jump back in and tap the three dots and add it back to favorites, it will now appear under the favorites list. Next, we have filters, which is likely an underutilized feature, but in fact, it's actually my recommended way to make sure you find the information you need quickly. I have a view filter to show tasks I'm waiting on. If I tap on one rule, I can see the filter I've added, which displays only tasks with the status set to waiting on. When I tap on this view name, you will see that there are several other views, each with unique filters set up to display exactly the task that I need to see at that point in time. Next, let's talk about relation property. It's a slightly advanced feature, but I think it's what makes Notion powerful. Opening up this project page, you might remember how I linked a saved YouTube reference to it. In my opinion, the relation property is an efficient way to actually see what you need quickly, provided you actively make those connections as you save new information to Notion. I won't go into how to set up a relation property from scratch, since that will probably need a more dedicated video. However, here's a quick tip for those of you who already use the relation property. If I go into editing this property and click on show as, you can see I currently have as page section selected. By default, when you set up a relation property, it will appear like any other property at the top. So again, simply go into editing the property and then click on show as and then try out the page section option, which I think makes viewing and accessing the related information much easier. So I hope that helps if you are already using the relation property. Lastly, we have the classic digital method for finding information, the search feature. You can enter keywords for what you're looking for, such as parameter, and it will display relevant pages, including matches with the page content. If you were to click on the filter icon beside the search field, you can actually do a slightly more specific search, like looking for title only. And of course, with all of us now taking advantage of AI, we have the option to use Ask AI to provide a summary of everything relevant to our search. I find this feature particularly useful when you remember writing about a topic, but can't remember the exact title and contents of the note. Ask AI feature can quickly surface the exact page you're looking for with the proper prompts and context. So this can possibly save you some time and effort in retrieving information. That's pretty much how I use my phone as a capture and retrieval tool. If you do struggle with your phone and need some more ideas, do check out the video on screen on how I set up my phone to help me stay focused. Thanks for watching and see you on the next video.